Hey guys, today I will be doing an in-depth analysis of the skills of the hero Juggernaut. Today I'll be going over each of his skills and what are some of the little tricks that you guys could do to improve your gameplay of the hero Juggernaut. First, we'll talk about the skill Blade Fury. Blade Fury does damage to a nearby hero or unit, so in order to do damage, you need to keep up with the hero. Traditionally, you want to move with the hero. However, here I am showing a trick where clicking the move button so that your hero will automatically follow the hero. For most people, using the Q, W, E, R keys, the move button will be M, and I suggest you guys change this key to a key closer, such as T or Y, so that after you click Q to spin, you could automatically click, because M is at the farther edge of the keyboard. For those who are using the legacy keys, Blade Fury will have the hotkey F. Here you could also change it to G or H so that you could use these two buttons almost in conjunction with each other. Now, if we take a look at some of the different ways that the hero could get away from you once you are using this technique, one way is for the hero to move up a hill or fog you. However, we'll see that if your vision is not completely obstructed, your hero will actually continue to follow the hero. Here we'll spin around this tree, and I will use the Blade Fury. Then you see I clicked M very quickly there, and clicked onto this hero, or the move button, sorry, not M, guys. And here he will try to juke me up the hill. I will Blade Fury and click move onto him. However, up the hill, I got juked this time because my vision was completely obstructed because I was farther away. Here, being close to him, as you see, I actually followed him up the hill. And now we try again. Following along this tree, I don't move my mouse, and here, right here, my vision is completely obstructed, and the hero gets away from me. Next, we're going to look at the second skill of Juggernaut, the healing ward. This is more mechanical as opposed to what you're doing to maneuver the ward. Now, the very basic thing is that you could actually select the ward as a unit, right-click onto your hero, and the ward will follow your hero. Here, I'll talk about how after the healing ward is destroyed, the duration of the healing will actually continue for another second or two. So, if you have the healing ward max at 5%, that's another 5% of your health. So when you have 2,000 health, that's 100. And in a 1 versus 1 situation, or in a juking situation, even if you just set the healing ward down, it will take the enemy 1 second to kill it. And afterwards, the healing ward will exist for another second, so you're getting 2 seconds of heal despite using it in a dangerous situation. Here we'll see it working. So, Pudge and I were hitting each other, I set the ward down, he hits it, and see this healing ward icon continued for 1 more second. So, third, we're looking at the skill Blade Dance. Now, this is pretty self-explanatory. It's a passive skill, it's a crit. There's not much to it. However, I like to show you guys something that works in conjunction with the item Shadow Blade. So normally, as you can see here on the screen, Juggernaut crits for 326, 300 something, when it has the item Shadow Blade solo. However, with the Shadow Blade activated, it actually counts the 150 bonus damage into the crit and doubles the 150 bonus damage. So here we'll look at some normal attacks. It's critting for 300 damage. Now afterwards, with the Blade Fury activated, if I crit out with the Blade Fury, it's 600 damage. If my Blade Fury first hit is a crit, bam, it's 600 damage. It is accounting the 150 damage and doubling it. Therefore, Shadow Blade is a really good item for mobility, for ganking, for escape, as well as for extra DPS output. Now, later you will see how this Shadow Blade with the 30% attack speed works even better with its ultimate. Juggernaut's ultimate is called Omni Slash. The hero Juggernaut jumps around and slashes at different enemies on the field for 9 hits. So, most beginner players, what they focus on and what they should focus on is not using this skill when their enemy creeps, not using this skill near neutral creeps, so that every single hit will land on an enemy hero. But contrary to what this skill says, it's actually not 9 attacks per se. This skill puts in account your attack speed bonuses. So instead of just stacking damage, you will actually significantly increase your damage output if you increase your attack speed once your damage goes to a certain level. So right now I'll show you guys two times Omni Slash, one with attack speed and one without. First, we'll look at how much Juggernaut does with three rapiers as his item. We'll be using this on a Pudge with magical resistance so that we will minimize the amount of magical damage dealt through the 175 to 250 damage per slash. With three rapiers, you're doing 1,000 damage per hit, right? So the Pudge has 7,000 health. We'll see how much damage you do. Here, the Pudge, as you can see, is being Omni Slashed. After the Omni Slash completes, you have 2,700 health left. Now, if we go up and we boost our items with three different Hyperstones, if it's just 9 attacks, then this shouldn't have a boost on the damage output at all. However, as we see, the Pudge gets completely destroyed with just one Omni Slash after boosting the attack speed of the hero. Now, what does this mean? Well, this means that it becomes an algorithm how much we boost our damage as opposed to how much we boost our attack speed. With our damage at 1,000, if had we gone for another rapier, our damage would be at 1,300. But with the boost of 55 attack speed, we're boosting our attack from 1,000 to boost of 55% to 1,500. So that's why I was talking about the item Shadow Blade earlier.